During the evening hours of September 4th, 2016, the Lord Jesus Christ spoke to my heart about an upcoming military invasion in the middle of the night via the southwestern shorelines of the United States. The Lord has shared with me that this attack will be considered as a terrorist attack, but it is actually the first stages of an all-out invasion of the Russian and Chinese troops upon the soil of the United States. The Lord has shared with me that the governments of the world have been planning this attack in different stages, and that it will come after a time of natural disasters that are brought upon this nation by HAARP weather technology. This weather machine technology has the ability to cause hurricanes and tornadoes and even firestorms in which lightning bolts with real fire come shooting from the skies. This event will be a trigger for North Korea to send its own missiles to the United States as a means to weaken our infrastructure from a different shoreline. These events are clearly stated within the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 as a warning from Moses to the children of God of what can happen when we turn away from our relationship with God. This passage, which is commonly called the blessings and the curses, is a very clear reminder that unless our nation truly, truly repents and turns its heart towards the Lord, that the Lord will allow all of the curses within this passage to also occur upon the United States soil. Hey, we have forgotten our first love. We have turned away from God, and we are already a fallen nation serving the gods of distant lands. We even have the very first Baphomet statue erected in Detroit, Michigan, in honor of Satan. Have you seen these statues, friends? They're about 9 feet tall. They weigh a ton. There's two children, one on each side, looking up to the image of Satan with adoration in their eyes that he's going to give them whatever it is that they desire. What an abomination to our Lord. And, you know, we have more bloodshed upon our soil than all the wars combined with our abortion industry. And we have even allowed same-sex marriage in every state. This is not new information. These things are an abomination to the Lord of hosts. And the same-sex marriage ruling from the Supreme Court, it breaks the first covenant that was established in the Garden of Eden, that marriage is between a man and a woman. There are no exceptions to the Lord's definition of marriage. And you can imagine how very grieved our Creator's heart is. How much further can our nation fall from the Lord? We have fallen so far from God that without a literal and spiritual shaking upon this land, that very few persons would even make it to heaven in the days ahead. Remember that whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. The Lord's great mercy will allow many to call upon His name and be accepted into heaven by the skin of their teeth. He is mercy. He operates from His divine mercy seat, and it is His desire to be merciful to His creation at the most wicked time period upon this planet. Please thank the Lord for this attribute of His, that He has even allowed many of our ancestors access into His heavenlies. We are a blessed people to have a heritage with our King. Now, before I read the words of the Lord Jesus, I want to say to all the mockers and scoffers out there who just, they take the time to write unkind remarks with the F-bomb and other various letters directed at the messengers, the prophets, and towards our precious King and Messiah. Hey, I am praying for you. I am fasting and praying for each of you that the Lord will be merciful to you. I thank the Lord that He is slow to anger and patient and loving, because when you come against the messages of the Lord, you are inviting wrath upon your own heads. You really, really are. You are the ones that the Lord is reaching out to. The ones out there who say that the Lord doesn't even exist, or that the Lord doesn't need to send messengers or prophets, and that all these messages are really just a big hoax. Listen, if you could, just for a minute, consider that these messages could be true, which they are, and ask the Lord sincerely to show you in His own special way. He will honor His word, as we read in Matthew chapter 7, verses 7 through 8. Ask and it shall be given. Ask the Lord if these messages are true. Seek and you will find. Seek the Lord on it. Read through the Holy Scriptures. And then knock and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks, that's you, mockers and scoffers, everyone who asks, and I believe that means reverently, they will receive. And anyone who seeks, they will find. And to the one who knocks, the door will be open. This verse is just for you mockers and scoffers as an invitation to each of you to sincerely test the spirit of the message and ask the Lord if it's true. Jesus Christ is not capable of lying, and if you ask Him, He will surely find a way to confirm that these messages are from Him. His words are golden, and He is not a man that He should lie, neither the Son of Man that He should repent. Whatever He says, it is going to come to pass. So stretch out your faith and see what happens, and in the meantime, I am never going to stop giving up on you. As I read through your comments and I see your names, I just lift you up in prayer. And I believe that the Lord will answer my prayer and He will reach out to you. So expect big things to happen, you mockers and scoffers. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, on to the message of the Lord Jesus Christ concerning the military invasion of Russia and China into the United States. These are the words of our King and Savior, Jesus Christ. To my dearest ones, children, the children who reside in the United States of America, this correspondence is directed especially towards you, and it is at this late hour that I wish to share some of the plans of the enemy against you. Dearest ones, the New World Order has already been formulated and is ruling in its secret offices across the planet. It appears as though your democracy is still in operational order, but I can assure you that whatever you are seeing upon your television and computer screens is a farce. It is a lie. It is birthed from the pits of hell as the demonic organization of the Pope and Barack Obama has completely sabotaged everything that represents freedom upon your land. Your banks have not yet collapsed. Your education system is still operational, and your military still has the appearance that it is functional only because of the power of my Holy Spirit upon the planet. As soon as I remove my precious Holy Spirit upon your planet, complete pandemonium will break out across your land, and events and circumstances will dramatically change. I will remove the youngest of the children first, and then I will rapture my precious bride. I will begin to send my holy bride out to walk the streets and sharing the unperverted gospel with the lost. Listen carefully, my children. I say unperverted gospel because for too long, preachers have been stealing money from my precious children to line their wallets. They have been teaching of how to get ahead while living on the earth instead of storing up treasures for you in my heavenly kingdom. They have been dressing in fancy clothes, silk ties and linen suits. All the while I have children sleeping beneath bridges and in cardboard boxes all across this planet. There are entire families sleeping in automobiles, trying to stay warm on a cold night. And soon there will be nowhere anyone can run from the presence of the Antichrist. He will hunt you down and ask you to take the symbol of his name. He will pursue you. He will entice you. After a short while, when his temper has gotten the best of him, he will then begin hauling many of you to his detention camps for retraining and education of how to live in his new world order. You see, dearest ones, he has created his own utopia, and in his utopia, he is the king, and you must do things his way. There is no free will when it comes to the Antichrist or the false prophet. There is his order from his created chaos, and then there is his own type of mind control. He will try to control and micromanage every sector of the planet for his own glory. People will love him too, for a season. After this season has expired, he will then begin eliminating my holy children systematically because they are the last remaining Christians upon the planet. He wants his planet to be free from the presence of your Creator, and so he has come up with many ways to annihilate you should you be left behind. He has come up with ways to bring rampant disease, pestilence, and even martial law across the entire globe. He is salivating to accomplish all of his warped plans, dearest ones. He is salivating. He is scheming at all hours of the night and day. He has his own team of confidants that he works with to help guide him in the transition phase of this plan. Every loophole and every backup plan has also been discussed in the late hours of the night. While my holy children are sleeping, the Antichrist has been quite busy coming up with clever ways to affix the mark of his name, the mark of the beast, to implement his own world religion. You will see these things unfolding in the days ahead, and you will wish that you had taken my messengers and prophets more seriously. It will be the worst time that this planet has ever experienced. I am calling all of my children to repentance today. Turn away from your lifestyles of sin. If you are worshiping any other god or gods other than me and my Father, then you must repent today. Repent or face your punishment in hellfire for forsaking the name of your Creator. I have been loving and kind, merciful and just, and now it is the time for sinners everywhere to repent. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. The kingdom of the one true King is at hand. Be thankful that out of my great mercy, that I even send messages at all, dearest ones. I know that many of you are reading the end times messages from the Lord. Many of you are mocking them too, and you must be careful not to mock the words of my messengers, because when you are mocking them, you are actually mocking me. I do not take this lightly, and neither does my Father. Please come to me today, my little lost sheep, for I want to escort you to safety. The only place of safety is in my capable arms. Do what you know that you need to do today. Tomorrow is never guaranteed. Love, Lord Jesus.